Okay, so I'm going to come from down, coming in this downward direction. And I'm going to be coming down, but not too far down, because then I want to end up around on the other side. So, okay, my part is actually not too bad. Not too bad. It's not too bad. I just need to fix it on this side. So, taking my rat tail, I want this to come here. So right across the top of the ear. I always, whenever I'm cornrowing, I always use grease plus gel at the same time to put on the hair. It just gives me a smoother cornrow. And again, with a little bit of stickiness with the black gel helps me grab when I'm braiding. So starting here, just doing my cornrows. Anyway, so this is what I have. I had to not use this section. I'll have to incorporate that into the top. And so this is what I have in the back. So not too shabby considering I can't see, even though the spacing in between is a little bit, you know, off. But just because my hair in the bottom is finer and thinner than it is up top. So there's the back. All right, so now I'm going to start fooling around with the top. So this is the center of my head. So go over about an inch, part up and around, because I need a little section here. Okay, so once I have that section, I need to braid this off. So, not braid it off, but you know, just put in a big chunky braid just to get it out of my way. Okay, so I just did these here, but let me let you see what my other part that I made. I stopped right here, about right where that hairline starts here, and made a part around to the top here to separate this section. It'll all make sense, you know, in the final look, but I just want you guys to see that other part. So I'll continue braiding this way, and then I'll come back when I start braiding this section. So again, this section, I'm gonna continue in this direction, just starting, you know, from this part is where I'm leading from and coming this way. So that all my braids, my loose edges end up over here. That's what I'm getting to, okay? Okay, so I have just about that part done. I don't want these to end up dead on my forehead, so what I'm gonna do is break open this section here. And I want to carry this over from here. Make that meet that part right there. So let me make that even. See on the top here? I'm trying to just bring that around. So hard to look and show you guys at the same time. So let me use a clip just to hold this till I get this together. There. Okay, so I'm gonna do with these, or just make, you know, maybe four, however many braids I can fit, this go all the way across here. All right, so again, the picture you saw at the beginning, this is what it takes to get there. So it is what it is. Now, if you can't braid, if you cannot cornrow, do small flat twists. If you can't do flat twists, then do small finger rolls. You know what a finger roll is. It's where you just, ow, where you just take the hair and just roll it like this. But take smaller sections, or you can make them bigger. You know, it's just about getting the hair in the direction of that original, of the first picture, so you can get the final style. Because the part that we do at the ends is very easy. Anybody's able to do that. It's just really just getting, you know, setting, doing the parts and getting your hair styled in the other parts in order to get it set over. I just said a whole lot of nothing just now. Anyway, so let me get to braiding on this section, and I'll be back. The next section I'll tackle is this one. All right, so I got these little three in the front. They're a little thicker, but that's fine. I didn't braid up all every last one of my edges because I sure enough am not gonna have my own head bumping up. Grease. Anyway, so now I'm dealing with this section, which I'm just gonna be braiding up this way, up that way. Okay, easy, simple, breezy cover girl. Anyway, don't ask me how long it took to do this style, because what you think? Yeah, it's taken a little while. It takes me longer to do my own hair. More time was spent because the parting in the back, I had to do it over and over and over again. Each part before I could get ready to braid it. So I do other people's hair a whole lot faster than I can do my own. Anyway, that's all. That's my rant for this segment. I'll be back. So this whole section will be individual braids, I think. I don't know. I'm gonna get started. I need to think for a second. Think. Yep, that's what it'll be. Individual box braids. So that's easy enough. You don't have to watch me do that. I'll just be parting with my finger, making a box braid. Sections will be about that big. What's that, about a half inch all the way around? So that'll be the size of those sections. So let me get going, because I got other stuff to do today. Bye.
So, like I was saying, twist up here. Keep grabbing braids as you twist up. So this is essentially like a finger roll when I'm doing it with the braided hair. I'm gonna do one by one. So each one, I'm gonna end up doing a pin curl and rolling it around. So for each of these braids in this individual section, I will take it. So look here. Take the hair, put one finger, if your hair is shorter like mine, or two fingers, if your hair is longer, to help you, you know, start your roll. And you just roll it around like a cinnamon roll. And you roll it all the way up till you get to the root. And when you lay it down, make sure it's covering some part of your scalp. Doesn't matter if it's the scalp that's to the left or the right of the braid, because at some point we're going to get all this covered. And then you pin it down. Alright? Where'd it go? Oh yeah. Right there. I should move that over. Well, this one can cover that piece. Okay, so I'm gonna do this one, pin it, this one, pin it. All right, so there we have it. This is my flower bunch. That's what I'm gonna call it. This is my stem, and there's my flowers. It's all twisted over on the sides. You can see what it looks like here. And again, when I tie it down, so strange looking at stuff in the mirror, then that'll lay down some of the frizzies. Now, if your hair is longer, then yours will be fuller and it'll really stand out more on the side of your head. If your hair is not longer, you can, you know, of course, add hair just to the ends. So, you know, cornrow your own hair, and then to the ends is where you would add in some, braid in some hair. And that way when you do your rolls, it can be fuller and really stick out off the side of your head. Another idea, like let's say you're doing this as an updo for a wedding. You can add, you know, at a Joann Fabrics or any craft store, they have those mini flowers. And so if you have your rosettes or your little flowerettes and you put little flowers, you know, inside of all of them, it'll basically make it like a whole bouquet on the side of your head.